Greetings. Well, there I was minding my own business, watching a video that made some claims about the Quran, and I decided to look up the surah this video mentioned. Surah 32:3. Let's begin at 32:1 and read it in context. 32:1, Alif Lam Mim. 32:2, finally we get to actual text that's intelligible. This scripture, meaning the Quran, free from all doubt, has been sent down from the Lord of the Worlds. I think that's the fourth in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. 32:3, or do they say, he has forged it? Nay, it is the truth from your Lord, that you may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you, that they may follow the right direction. And my head went, tilt! Allah is giving Muhammad the answer. Allah is giving Muhammad the response to a hypothetical challenge. Or do they say, he, meaning Muhammad, has forged it? Can you get the context? Self-rationalization. And Allah gives this as the answer. Pay close attention to the details. Nay, so this is Allah contradicting the claim of its forgery. Nay, it is the truth from your Lord that you may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you, Muhammad, that they may follow the right direction. Seems straightforward enough. The Quran does claim that every nation has had a warner sent to it. And now the Quran is simply making the claim that finally the Quran has been sent to a nation, the Arab nation, that has never had a warner before. That you, Muhammad, may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you. Muhammad, Muhammad, Muhammad. Tell them this, 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 straight, 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 from Allah, la, 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 myself, self, 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 self. Tell them, 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 I have never, ever, 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 ever sent a warner, 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 to the Arabs, 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 before, 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 before. I have never, ever, ever, ever sent a prophet, 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 to the Arabs, 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 before, 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 before you, 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 you. Okay, Texas, what's your point? Well, according to Islam, who built the Kaaba? This is not a hard question, or it should not be. Islam claims Abraham built the Kaaba. Fair enough, they can claim what they want. But think about it. Doesn't that beg a question? If Islam claims Abraham is a prophet, a warner, a messenger. And Islam claims Abraham lived in Mecca and built the Kaaba. How can the Quran claim no warner has ever been among them or sent to the Arab people before Muhammad? Were the Arabs of Abraham's time completely and absolutely oblivious to his form of worshiping Yahweh? That you, Muhammad, may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you. Am I the only one seeing a glaring deficiency in this Quranic claim? Do you see the problem? Now you have to put yourself in the mind of a Mohammedan. Scary, I know. If you had to make up an excuse for this, how would you rationalize away this problem? Well, the obvious answer is the same as they imagine for Muhammad claiming he is the first Muslim. 6:163, he hath no associate. This am I commanded, and I am the first of Muslims. And then Muhammad contradicts himself by naming other first Muslims, or earlier Muslims. 3:52, we are Allah's helpers. We believe in Allah, and do thou bear witness that we are Muslims. So 600 years before Muhammad, there were other first Muslims. You add to the incomplete and confused Quran. That's how you solve the problem. You add to the Quran. You add, of your group. Muhammad, you are the first Muslim of your group. Now, the Quran doesn't say that, does it? But see how easy it is to fix the Quran. Any person called the first Muslim then becomes the first Muslim of that group, of that situation. So when Allah says that Muhammad is the first prophet to ever visit the Arab descendants of Ishmael, you add whatever change you need to make up an acceptable version of the claim. What the Quran really says is that you may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you. Now, how men must change it to fix the Quran, that you may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you since the other warners left. Or since last month. They were only here a while ago. Or since Abraham died. So, O Muslim, how do you excuse Allah's forgetfulness? You may warn a people to whom no warner has come before you. Oh, crap. Forgot a god, about Abraham, Ham. Jibreel, ill. Get back here. I have to abrogate, again. I forgot Abraham, Ham. Think this through with me, Muslim, and maybe you will understand. If Abraham was a prophet, and Abraham lived with the Arabs, do you think Abraham completely hid his monotheism from the pagan Arabs he was with? What about hiding Yahweh from Ishmael and his family and their descendants? Or do you think Abraham, like all the messengers and prophets and warners, did not have his copy of the scriptures? That is what the Quran says, right? Every nation has had a warner, a prophet who had two scriptures with them. Surah 35:24. We have sent you as an announcer and a warner about the truth. No nation exists unless some warner has passed among them. Their messengers brought them explanations, the Psalms, and an enlightening book. Well, was Abraham a prophet? A warner? Surah 32:3 claims there had never been a warner to the people Muhammad was sent to. But then I imagine you will twist the meaning in your head to mean whatever excuses you feel comfortable with. But if you have any desire for the truth, examine this contradiction in the Quran. Realize this is the kind of mistake a man makes when he claims to write a book from God. Whether it is getting confused who the first Muslim was, or getting confused creating a rationale to try and refute a hypothetical challenge of your prophethood, if you believe that Abraham was a prophet and lived in Arabia during the building of the Kaaba, you have some very hard questions to answer. Why is there no record of these scriptures, the Quran claims, that Prophet Abraham brought to Arabia? Why was there no presence of Muslims or Islam in the Arabian Peninsula before Muhammad? If Abraham was a prophet of Islam, why is there no evidence of any group which Abraham started praying in the stilted and ritualistic way that Mohammedans do today? But maybe, just maybe, the Quran is right. Muhammad was the first and only prophet, messenger, warner, ever sent to Arabia, ever to visit Arabia. Muhammad was sent that he may warn a people to whom no warner has ever come before. Which maybe proves Abraham was never in Arabia. Or else he would have been the first warner, or at least a previous warner. After all, to be fair, the Quran never limits the number of warners or prophets to any nation. Or Abraham was not a prophet of Islam, which would seem a dodge you Mohammedans should be willing to try. Along the lines that Abraham was a prophet but not a warner, or he had no message and therefore was a prophet but not a messenger. It makes as much sense. Or perhaps you should consider the obvious. The Quran is false. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.